Hello viewers, welcome to CSS World. In this video, we will cover an important topic of the discipline international relations. The topic of today's lecture is foreign policy. Under this lecture, we will cover the following topics: foreign policy, stages in foreign policy, determinants of foreign policy, Graham Allison's three models of foreign policy decision making, national interests, and types of national interests. So here we go. First of all, we will try to understand the definition of foreign policy. Foreign policy is basically strategies that governments use to guide their actions in the international arena. The actions state leaders decide to pursue and protect national interest in given situations. In short, we can say that foreign policy is designed to protect and promote the national interests abroad. Now, what are those stages through which foreign policy decision maker go through to devise the foreign policy? These stages include assessment of international and domestic political environment, goal setting, determination of policy options, formal decision making process, and implementation of chosen policy option. Foreign policy of a country is always designed according to some determinants. It is always devised by external and internal factors faced by the countries. External factors include country's position in power structure, country's standing in international organizations, geographic location of country, world public opinion or public perception regarding the country, and international alliances. Whereas internal factors include military power, type of government and leadership ruling the country, size of the country, its geography, resources, quality of diplomacy, role of media and think tanks. Now we will move towards Graham Allison's three models of foreign policy decision making. Graham Allison is an American political scientist and professor at the John F. Kennedy School of Government at Harvard. He is renowned for his contribution in the late 1960s and early 1970s to bureaucratic analysis of decision making, especially during times of crisis. He presented three models of foreign policy decision making. Here is the first model of foreign policy decision making presented by Graham Allison. This model is named as rational actor model. According to this model, a decision maker sets goals first of all and then evaluates the relative importance of these goals. After evaluating their relevant importance, he calculates the cost and benefits for each possible course of action. Then he chooses the one with the highest benefit and low cost. Second method of foreign policy decision making presented by Graham Allison is organizational process model. This model shows the pressures that organizations place on decision makers' choices. This model assumes objectives are already set. Standard operating procedures or SOPs are followed. These SOPs enhance efficiency. Third model of foreign policy decision making presented by Graham Allison is bureaucratic model or government bargaining model. In this model, key individuals in critical positions have great influence. They have different priorities and they have different organizational positions and commitments. After going through the topic of foreign policy, now we will move towards the topic of national interest. The goals that the states pursue to maximize what they perceive to be selfishly best for their country are collectively known as national interest. The most important national interest is survival of the state. Security, stability, prosperity are the cherished national interest of every nation. The more precise definition of national interest is given by Hans J. Morgenthau. According to him, political traditions and political cultural context within which a nation formulates its foreign policy is known as national interest. Here are some types of national interest. First one is primary interest. It is regarding the physical territorial integrity, cultural identity, guarding against external aggression, whereas secondary interests are related to protection of diaspora living abroad. On the other hand, general interests are in the field of trade, diplomacy, and international relations or international law. And permanent interests are those which can uphold their permanence. This was all from today's lecture. Like and subscribe for more videos. Goodbye.